Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain three different methods that we are going to implement with the help of C language. So these three methods will be traverse, count nodes, and calculate sum of nodes. And all three methods will be related to single aliases, right? So I am going to tell you how you can implement individual methods with the help of C language related to this concept. So before starting, let me first create a linked list. So suppose this is a start pointer. Then we have first node. This is node number one. Node number two. And this is node number 3. Now these are values which are stored in these nodes. This is the base address of first node, which is stored here. Base address of second node, which is stored here. And base address of third node, which is stored here. And third node link part is containing null. So this way, this single linked list is connected, right? And each node is internally divided into two parts. So if we see this node, so its first part is known as info and second part is known as link or next, and it will be a pointer, right? So if we traverse a particular linked list, so we need to traverse each node those are available in the linked list. So now I am going to tell you how you can implement your first method, that is to traverse a single linked list, right? So before starting, let me first explain the structure as well. So if you create any linked list, so first you need to create a structure. So right now I am telling you how you can create structure for this node. So its first member will be int info and its second member will be struct node pointer link, or here you can also write next. So whatever name you want to use, you can use. So we will be using link because in my algorithmic videos I also use link for this second part. So we will be printing link and I am using this. So this is basically the structure that we use to create any node in C language, right? So I hope you understood this, how we can create node with the help of this structure. So if you want to create these nodes and you want to insert values, so for that purpose you need to watch my another video that is related to insert element into linked list. But in this video we are going to focus only on these three functions. So now I am going to write first method, so it will be void traverse, then struct node pointer start. So this method will be calling from the main function, and from main function we are going to pass this start. So start always contains base address of the first node. So first node address we will be passing from the main function, and that will be received with this start node. Right now, through this start pointer, we are going to traverse each and every node of this linkage. So now, here I am declaring one node pointer. So struct node pointer ptr, and I am assigning start into ptr. So ptr is also a pointer which is of type struct node. So it will be containing the address which is available into start. So start will be passing 1001. So ptr will be pointing to 1001. So here I am creating one more pointer whose name is ptr, and ptr will also be containing 1001. It means ptr is pointing to this one, right? Now I am implementing a loop while ptr not equals to null. So if ptr is not equals to null, then only this loop will be executed, otherwise it will be terminated. So now inside this loop, so we are going to implement a function for traverse polynomials. So in case of traverse, I am going to print the values which are available in this info part of the loop. So for that purpose, I am writing printf backslash t percent d. Now here you need to carefully see this. Whenever you access any member of structure through structure pointer, so ptr is a structure pointer, so you need to use this arrow notation. So I am going to use ptr arrow, and here I am writing info and then sidebar, right? And then ptr equals to ptr arrow link. So this way this loop is completed, and I am closing this method here. So now I am going to explain each and every step that are written in this loop, how it will be executed. So starting from here, ptr is continuing start. So ptr is having 1001, so it is pointing to first node. Then check this condition, ptr not equals to null, which is true. Then print ptr info. So this notation is arrow. So if you want to type this in the program, so first you need to type hyphen and then greater than sign. So by pressing these two keys, you will be typing this arrow notation. So ptr is a pointer, and through pointer we are going to access info part of the node. So node info part is 10 that I already explained you with this diagram. So what will be printed on output screen? 10. So first output will be 10. Then ptr equals to ptr link. So ptr is pointing to 1001, and 1001 link part is containing 2001, and that will be stored into ptr. So new value of ptr will be 2001. It means now ptr is pointing to this node, right? So whenever you want to jump from one node to another, then you need to write this in C program, right? So now ptr is pointing to second node. Check while condition ptr not equals to null, so it is true. So ptr will be printing its information. So right now ptr is pointing to 2001, and its information part is 20. So next output will be printed as 20. And here we are using backslash t. So tab space will be there between these two values. If you want to print them in separate lines, so you can use backslash n in place of backslash t. Now again ptr equals to ptr name. So ptr is pointing to 2000 address, and at this position link value is 3001. So this time ptr will be having new value as 3001, and ptr is pointing to third node. So this way I hope you understood how this loop is working. So again we need to check this condition, ptr not equals to null, which is true. Then ptr info will be printed. So right now it is 30, so 30 will be printed. Again ptr will move to link of ptr. So this time ptr is pointing to 3001, and its link is having null. So this time ptr will be having null. Now check this condition, it is false, because ptr is equals to null. So where it will be false, so loop will be terminated. And here you can see all three values which are available into three separate nodes are printed on output screen. So this way I explain you how we can implement a function in C language that will traverse each node of a serial loop, right? And this is the structure through which you can create node. So how this structure will be used, so that you can understand while you will be watching a video related to how we can insert a node into a lineage. So that video is also available in the playlist. So if you want to watch algorithm video, if you want program implementation using C related video, and actual code implementation with the help of any compiler, so all video related playlists are available in description of this video. So if you go to the description of this video, you will find various links of playlists. So you can open them and you can search the videos related to linkages. So you can watch all kind of videos, like how to implement algorithm, how we implement those algorithms with the help of C program, and how these programs are implemented. implemented on compiler actually, right? So after this traverse, now I am going to tell you how you can count nodes. So we will be converting this code only. So here I am going to declare one more variable that is C equals to 0. Return type of this method will be int. Name of this method will be count. And instead of printing values, I am going to write C++. So this loop will repeat whenever PTR is not equals to null, and PTR will be null when it will be reaching to the end node. So this way, this loop will count each and every node. So whatever the value of count will be, so after completion of this loop, you can return value of C to main function. So again, main function will be calling this count function and will be passing the value which is available into start pointer. That will be stored in this start pointer into this function. Then we are assigning it into PTR. Through PTR, we are rotating the loop and counting how many nodes are available. And after completion of this loop, we can return the value of C to the main function. So I hope you understood how easily we modify the traverse function into count node function. So the second is also completed, and now I think you can easily write the function for sum of node values. So we need to add 10, 20, 30 together so that we can print the sum of information which are available in each node of single input. So what we need to do, I am declaring variable in s equals to 0, and here I have to write s equals to s plus PTR info. So whatever value is available into PTR info, so PTR will be pointing to a particular node, and each node is having information part. So that info will be added into s and will be stored into s variable. And after completion of the loop, sum will be available into s, and you can return value of s. And instead of writing count, here you can write sum. So friends, this way I explained you all three methods that we can write with the help of C language code. And I also explained how we can write algorithms related to these three topics, like how to traverse linkages, how to count code, how to calculate sum of code. So if you want to watch like how we can write algorithms for these points related to single linkages, so again I am telling you, you can go to description, find the playlist links and watch videos related to linkages there. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.